Tell me about Islam, Iman, and Ihsan. The key words in this lesson are Islam, Iman, Ihsan. We will learn what they are, inshallah. Astonished means to be amazed. Truth, the hour. The hour is the day of judgment or the Qiyamah. We're going to learn in this lesson what is Islam, what is Iman, what is Ihsan. We're going to learn about the pillars of Islam. We're also going to learn about when the day of judgment is, and I can tell you now that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. We're also going to learn about some of the signs of the day of judgment. The hadith we have here today is an Umar radiyallahu anhu aydan qal بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم إذ طلع علينا رجل شديد بياض الثياب شديد سواد الشعر لا يرى عليه أثر السفر ولا يعرفه منا أحد حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأسند ركبتيه إلى ركبتيه ووضع كفيه على فخذه وقال يا محمد أخبرني عن الإسلام فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الإسلام أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا رسول الله وتقيم الصلاة وتؤتي الزكاة وتصوم رمضان وتحج البيت إن استطعت إليه سبيلا قال صدقت فعجبنا له يسأله ويصدقه قال فأخبرني عن الإيمان قال أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره قال صدقت قال فأخبرني عن الإحسان قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك قال فأخبرني عن الساعة قال ما المسؤول عنها بأعلى من السائل قال فأخبرني عن أماراتها قال أن تلد الأمة ربتها وأن ترى الحفاة العراة العالة رعاء الشاء يتطاولون في البنيان ثم انطلق فلبثت مليا ثم قال يا عمر أتدري من السائل؟ قلت الله ورسوله أعلم قال فإنه جبريل أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم قال فإنه جبريل أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم I'll read the English translation. On the authority of Umar رضي الله عنه, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, while we were one day sitting with the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, there appeared before us a man dressed in extremely white clothes and with very black hair. No traces of journey were visible in him, and none of us knew him. He sat down close by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, rested his knees against the knees of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and placed his palms over his thighs, and said, O Muhammad, inform me about Islam. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, Islam is that you should testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That you should perform salah and pay the zakah, fast during Ramadan, and perform hajj to the house, to the Kaaba. If you can find a way to it, or find the means for making the journey to it. He said, you have spoken the truth. We were astonished at his thus questioning him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then telling him that he was right. But he went on to say, inform me about Iman. He, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, replied and answered, it is that you believe in Allah and his angels and his books and his messengers and in the last day and fate, qadr, both in its good and its evil aspects. He said, you have spoken the truth. Then the man said, inform me about Ihsan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered, it is that you should worship Allah as though you could see him. For though you cannot see him, yet he sees you. He said, inform me about the hour. He, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, about the one questioned knows no more than the questioner. So he said, well, inform me about its signs. He said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they are that the slave girl will give birth to her mistress, and that you'll see the barefooted ones, the naked, the destitute, the herdsmen of the sheep, competing with each other in raising lofty buildings. Thereupon the man went off. I waited a while, and then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, O Umar, do you know who that questioner was? I replied, Allah and His Messenger know better. He said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that was Jibreel. He came to teach you your religion. It's a long hadith. We'll explain the hadith inshallah. But first of all, we'll just look at the most important parts of this, the hadith. The hadith says, Ashhadu an tashhada an la ilaha, or al-Islam an tashhada an la ilaha illallah, wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, wa tuqimu salah, wa tu'ti zakah, wa tasumu Ramadan, wa tahujju al-bayta in istata'ta ilayhi sabila. If I go back to the hadith, as you can see in this hadith, that Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu says that one day while they were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and this was common of the Sahaba radiyallahu anhu, that they would sit gathering around Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this man appeared from nowhere, and he was dressed in extremely white clothes, so he wasn't someone who was traveling, nor was he someone who was a resident, because they couldn't tell, they didn't know him, and Medina was small, so everybody knew everybody at that time. So he sat, this person sat as a student of knowledge, very close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sitting respectfully, and he started asking Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam these questions. So these questions were very amazing, and the Sahaba was surprised, and they wasn't sure, is this person learning or is he teaching Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? They were a bit confused, but they used to like Bedouins coming, so they assumed that he was a Bedouin because he was speaking in a very rough way. He was saying, O Muhammad, and it's usually Bedouins that speak in that way. The Sahaba radiallahu anhu and the ones who lived in the city of Medina, they were taught to show respect and to say, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Nabiullah, or not to call Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam by his name. So they were completely astonished and surprised, and listening to him ask these questions, they were learning a lot. So they were learning a lot about Islam, and they were learning about Iman, and they were learning about the Ihsan. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned a couple of signs of the Day of Judgment, and he also mentioned that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows when the Day of Judgment will take place. So in this hadith you can see, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam summarized for us at the end of the hadith, that this hadith summarizes the whole religion. Okay, and that person, the angel actually, or that person in disguise, was Angel Jibreel alayhi salam. So you have the best teacher, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and Angel Jibreel also teaching us in the best way. And we're learning about the best religion, which is Islam.